All right, I am back. Game two was SY map back. So gonna have to head in and see what the map generator threw up and see if we had any change in personnel or whether it expanded to 4v4. Seems that the only change was Lix being introduced for China in place of Moonlight. This map is SY Raft, which I am not always a fan of when I see it, because sometimes it's a little bit unfair. The reason being that the way the map is made, the top left corner is the top left edge is always where the land touches, and the top right is always where the water is. And sometimes when you look at the positions of the players on the center land, it can lead to it being easier to kind of guard private fishing for one team or the other, depending on the layout of the players. But what we see here is pretty fair, because both teams are kind of lined up on the kind of right and left, top right and bottom left, if you will. But returning to that personnel change, still v3 3v3, but Lix replacing Moonlight or PBTD, helpfully in the red color still. Having a look at the civilizations, we see Zuppi playing Mongols once again in the blue, as the right flank for Finland. Zuppi Mongols is pretty standard for Finland, I think. Pike in the pocket with Mayans, although, okay, here we see Lick stealing a boar from presumably Max, and I heard a Phil go down. Oh no, it's a scout. Wow. So that is Lovechain losing his scout to Max, who's now on 3 HP. Lix has screwed up that boar steal a little bit, but he had enough HP to have another go. And Max is... okay, maybe there was some communication from Finland and Max is going to double back and try and deal with that. But the problem is that Lix's scout can literally just turn and kill Max's with one hit. But he's taking so much damage from this boar, and now like he might lose it. If Lix checks the HP, he can just turn around and kill the scout, but he may not be doing that whilst trying to micro. And ultimately, it would be lucky if this boar steal is successful. In fact, it might just manage, because Max still needs two more hits, and if a Vil comes out for Lovechain, it should get it. That's so close. Oh. Wow, 1 HP left on Lix's scout, and the boar makes it, so presumably that came from Max. We see one here. Don't see another one anywhere else. Right. So it was like Max and Pike were so close together, like it could conceivably have been Pike's. But anyway, yeah, Pike in the pocket. Ink green as the Mayans. Players pretty close together on this map though. So that, like, as pocket Mayans, you're not terribly far away from your allies in terms of being late to support them or anything. And then Max on the left flank in the teal playing as Persians, and down a boar as we just saw. Opposite him, Lovechain also playing as Persians, in the purple pocket for China's going to be Lix, in red as the Mongols, and that's pretty interesting. Yeo not being Mongols for China is unusual. Yeo's actually going to play Mayans and be on the right hand side in the yellow. So we've got Mayans v Mongols on the right hand side, and Persian Mirror on the left hand side, and Mayans v Mongols in the pocket. So, you know, we could see the two Persian players facing each other, basically having a private 1v1 on the left hand side, and then Mayans and Mongols having a 2v2 on the right hand side. That's very, very possible. I think overall though, I do just like having the Mongols in the pocket a tiny bit better on a map like this. So tiny advantage in civ position for China, although again not really terribly decisive. In terms of the kind of outer edge of the map, something interesting to note, if this goes like really late game, there's not a lot of gold on this right hand edge as compared to the left hand edge, which has four separate gold piles and one stone. Compared to what looks like, okay, actually, there's four stone on the right hand side and one gold. So similar amounts of resources, but a lot more gold on the left hand side for Finland to take from that left hand strip of land. taking a little bit look at a little bit of a look at what the players are doing early on. Love Chen going for this big palisade wall across the front, docking on the back. If he manages to completely wall himself off, I wouldn't be surprised to see him trying to do knights, go straight to knights, because actually trying to do this pretty big team wall across the front. Lex is going to extend that right the way across here, and presumably Love Cheng will seal this part off. Yo also just full wall straight away, docking down here. Interesting dock just outside the wall there. Not really any kind of team walling going on for China, sorry, for Finland, but every player has also docked, as you would expect. What we might see is the players that are down here going for more of a Grush approach. Zuppi going up on 25 population with 21 villages and 4 fishing ships, and then transitioning everything to wood and gold. So he's going to Grush. It's pretty important that the players in the bottom right, if they like, it's pretty important that they Grush, because they basically control the other team's access to their team's fishing behind the island. So what's interesting to me is the fact that Yo is not clicking up, and he's going to be a lot later to the feudal age, and therefore could be difficult for him to defend against a fast Grush from Zuppi. I'll have to see how that plays out. Like, the rest of the fishing for China is so far away that like, I don't think that will come under attack as a result, but Yo could certainly lose his fish and be losing on water in general, if indeed he can test the water at all. What we can see is Zuppi just going, you know, stereotypical Grush here. Second dock going to be up by the time he reaches the feudal age, and no doubt a third one shortly afterwards. A couple of stray sheep being picked up from Zuppi here by Lix. That scout has done work in this game, stealing it for his flanks as well. He stole a boar from Finland's left flank and stole 2 sheep from Zuppi's right flank. Zuppi hitting a few lades, getting double bit axe. Gonna see galleys from both docks, I should think. And third dock going up, Stonewall. So yeah, Stonewall Grush. Pretty predictable play there, whereas Yo going up quite a bit later on 32 population overall with 4 fishing ships. So he's not really going to be able to contest a fast Grush against Zuppi, but if he manages to hold on, he should have the better castle time off the back of that higher population click up. So Finland didn't prioritise that team wall as early as China did, but they're now really trying to make it happen for them. We saw Zuppi doing a ton of stone wall across the middle. Max just palisades for now, but Finland are really Xing everywhere, basically trying to get that full close off. Zuppi now making his way around the right hand edge of the map. Gonna be hitting Yo's fishing basically as Yo hits the feudal age, and should have 2 or 3 galleys on top of Yo's single dock. So like, Yo is not making extra docks at all. He's not bothered about Grushing. He's actually on stone heavily, so he's going to do plumes. He's going to play for land instead of water. And he's going to lose his fish. It remains to be seen whether any player for China, having done more of a fast castle in either the pocket or the kind of top flank, the safe flank position, will then make their way back around and try and reclaim water with castle age ships versus Zuppi's Grush. And that could be an option. Like, Lix could do some water in castle age, but you know, as Mongol pocket, he may choose to just focus on a boom on the land as well. Although giving up a complete fish boom to Finland would be potentially a misstep in strategic terms. See that Max over here is absolutely abusing this, the fishing and the fact that he's so safe up here. Love Cheng has got a decent number of fishing ships. He's got 9, but Max with 15, and Pike also doing the same. Like, so many more fishing ships on the map for Finland at the moment, so they're just gonna have a disgusting fish boom. And if we just look at population in general, it's just so much higher for Finland at this point, due to that, the fact that everybody's got some population on, well, more population on water, basically. And interestingly, Lix going coinage straight away at the start of Feudal Age. So I hadn't noticed that he hadn't done any kind of click up. He's done stable, blacksmith, then market, then coinage. That's, and he's gonna lose fish. So Yo's off water, Lix is basically off water, and Zuppi's making his way up to the northern part of the map, where Lovecheng will likely lose most of his fishing ships as well. So this is pretty interesting. Lix is gonna go with a sling towards Yo, who, as we saw, was on plumed archers. So we're gonna see China's strategy being focused on basically slinging Yo to the Imperial Age, as Mayans are making use of the fact that Mayans are just so, so strong at the start of the Imperial Age. Like, the first few minutes of the Imperial Age, they're just able to push so, so quickly. And when that Imperial Age is so much earlier as a result of getting sling, that's very, very deadly weapon indeed, and in the hands of Yo, no less. So, given that Zuppi is the kind of most delayed player for Finland, that could be very, very effective, because Zuppi, having done that Grush and hung around in the Feudal Age, expended resources on that, is going to be so, so, so far behind in just in terms of overall game state compared to Yo being Mayans, concentrating purely on the land and getting slinged on top of that. That's going to be a dramatic difference between the two, and a single layer of stone wall will not keep Yo out. Interestingly, Zuppi just flaring the back island here. It's like, I mean, there's a stone pile right where he's Xing there, but it's kind of an odd thing to be pointing out. Lovecheng going for some sort of fireship defense, and with two, he should be able to clean up most of those galleys unless they flee. But you have to say that the Grush for Zuppi has really done work. Like, it's taken away basically all of Yo's fishing, or basically all of Lix's fishing, a good amount of Lovecheng's, and what it hasn't, the fishing boats that haven't been destroyed have been heavily idled. Whilst for Finland, they have been fish booming like crazy, and actually have 40 fishing ships, and going to do a few fire ships as well, or at least Pike is, just to make sure that SY don't try and have a little bit more water presence at this point. And then take away Finland's fish boom a little later on. So Yo already on the way to the Imperial Age, just 8 seconds later than Zuppi clicking up to the Castle Age. With the stable for Lix, I wonder if it was kind of a feint, or whether they just changed their minds on the fly about what Lix should do. I'd really love to know that, but obviously there's no real way of knowing. But if it was a, just like putting a stable out on the front as a feint, would have been quite a nice thing if that was really what it was, although I don't know if it would really actually pay off. Like, you know, a feudal sling would become obvious once he remained in the Feudal Age for a couple more minutes than you would expect him to, so the value of spending that would probably lost, and it inclines me to think that they changed their strategy on the fly rather than actually it being any kind of trick. So Finland just dropping some X's to try and show where Yo is probing with his plumes, but he's going to be waiting until the early Imperial Age that he's almost about to hit before he really mounts any kind of push. So Zuppi will have a minute or two longer of safety before the reality of facing a slung early Imperial Age Mayan player whilst only just having hit Castle Age, having Grushed, dawns on him. But Finland are at least making another concerted push on the water now, taking away the couple of fishing ships that Jo had re-added, and they'll be able to move around and take away all of the fish that remains for China, albeit that isn't a lot anyway, in total only 6 in fact. So Jo with the immediate forward casserole, he can dump that right on the walls of Zuppi because he's got the map control already with the plumes that he's stationed on Zuppi's walls. University coming out for ballistics, and I assume we're going to see some siege workshops as well before long, as well as continuing to drop more castles, produce more plumes. So Zuppi can't fight this, and it seems that he's concluded that the best way for his team to fight this is for him to start slinging. So coinage kicking in for him, he's going to do war galley, so it's going to be a kind of mix of just continuing to hold down the water and then slinging his allies. So both Mongol players in this game slinging, and it's going to be between the Persians and the Mayans to fight it out for the foreseeable future. Let's have a look what's going on over here, because we haven't concentrated on it too much. See, Lovcheng basically just doing a bit of a Persian boom. Looks like there was a few dead bodies in there, so a little bit of conflict between probably knights from Max. Might have been one or two conversions kicked in or anything, but nothing besides a little bit of sporadic knight raiding. Zuppi presumably will lose that TC to that trebuchet. It looks like that's what it's firing on. Zuppi's just going to stone wall over and over again, just do his best to keep Jo out. Max will come over here and chase down a few of the extra plumes, but given that those are going to be elite plumes very soon with lots of upgrades and presumably being massed up quite nicely, once Jo really gets going, just a few castle age knights won't really be able to stop Yo's push. It's gonna take more, but Max is on the way to the Imperial Age at least, and he's probably gonna be the recipient of the sling by the looks of it. I will actually just take note the next time Zuppi sends resources to see where that's going. Lix is still tributing Jo at this point. Could be that one or two trebuchets go down for Jo though. He hasn't added enough plumes to really keep himself safe from just random, even just a handful of knights coming in from Max really, and that's going to slow down his push quite a lot if losing trebuchets like this. Zuppi's going to be able to continue to rewall quite nicely, and that will keep Jo out for quite a long time to come with his push losing momentum in that way. All of the water now belonging to Finland. Left hand side, Lovcheng showing a little bit of aggression with a mixture of monks, knights and camels, but Max is double stonewalled. It looks like Pike's been doing a lot of team walling to help out his team as well. So they're going to come down here and focus on shutting this down more or less, I think. Just try their best to stop them getting into Zuppi. It looks like this is going to be the best way for them to break through those walls as quickly as possible. And with both of the kind of top flanks, if you will, top left flanks, coming down here, we're going to see all of the players just grouping up to fight on the right hand side. Nice thing for Finland is that given Zuppi's success on the water, they will continue to exploit a free fish boom well into the late game here, whereas China don't have that luxury. And that's why the populations combined look a lot better for Finland at this point. Although, just looking at Jo's population, it's really not very high. Considering that he was continuing to receive sling from Lix, and that Lix didn't go castle age and just transition out of the sling at all. I might have expected to see him with a little bit more at this point. Pike himself is actually reaching the Imperial Age very, very soon, and although Jo will have the advantage in terms of upgrades over him for a little while longer, Jo still with just Bracer and no armor upgrades, no elite, and it won't be long until Finland are really ready to take a fight here. And Yo's push stands a decent chance of being halted here, I would say. Not before he's done good damage to Zuppi, but I don't think they're gonna kill Zuppi off here. I mean, if we look at Zuppi, like, the village accounts are low for him, but he has 23 fishing ships, which makes a big, big difference. And Yo, in combination with Lovecheng, has been completely forced back now. Like, Lovecheng is still Castle Age, whereas Max has managed it Imperial Age and get Cavaliers with +4, which basically tells you that the fish boom has been the decisive thing there. Max with 20 fishing ships, he and Lovecheng basically played the same game. They're both Persians, they're both on the top left flank, they both did a few stable units and skirmished a bit in the Castle Age, but ultimately didn't really commit. But the difference being, Max with 20 fishing ships hit the Imperial Age a lot earlier, and he's there with +4 Cavaliers, ready to push Yo away, basically. Whereas Lovecheng, not able to bring the same type of support down here to assist Yo. And now Pike is in the Imperial Age. He's got +3, +1. Yo finally with elite and +4. But Pike won't be far behind. For now, he's not getting elite, but he's going to get chemistry in. Given that that upgrade costs only food and wood, and he's supplemented by the fish boom and having a high population, 110 villagers and 20 fishing ships, it'll be really easy for him to get elite plumed archer in the next couple of minutes, you would think, unless he prioritizes other things like thumb ring, which he was missing. Gotta be careful that I don't make it seem like Finland have pushed this back already, but I certainly feel like they're in with a very good chance of taking a decisive engagement in the minutes to come, when they feel that they're ready in terms of upgrades. Because the push has basically been stalled at this line for such a long time now, and it's given Zuppi space. Like, he hasn't got tons of space, but it's given him space to retreat, because he hasn't been constantly losing villages, losing population. He's still got access to his main gold, to wood, to the fish, which he's actually added docks in lots of new places, which Finland can continue to do, like, all the way up here, really, until they get to the where the Team Wall of China keeps them out. And Max even starting trade right now. Interesting to see where they trade to. Looks probably going to be like here, or maybe just within Pike's base, maybe to here. But now we can see that the ground that had been gained by Yo's push on the right hand side is starting to be taken back by Finland, beginning to erect fortifications here, throwing up a castle, so they'll reclaim this line, basically. And the amount of trebs for Pike is awesome, and it's going to knock down one of Yo's forward castles basically instantly. And Paladin now kicking in for Max, which is again just faster than Lovecheng. It means that there was no way, like, even if Yo had been pushing in here more, you know, Lovecheng would have been outmatched, and Yo would have been outmatched by the fact that Paladin upgrade kicked in faster for Max. And now Pike just pack up those trebs, move forward a little bit, and can take down another castle in basically two volleys. And Pike getting coinage himself, so he'll probably luck to get Zuppi back into the game a little bit by sending him some extra resources at least. I shouldn't imagine it will be a full sling, because Pike really has a job to do in terms of fighting together with Max here, but some extra resources from a pop cap from Iron Player and the post-Imperial Age note going to be very helpful to get Zuppi into the game. Lix is on his way to the Castle Age, so he's probably going to be completely stopping slinging now and trying to get into the game himself, bring the Mongols into it, and he's going to have a a head start over Zuppi in doing that, possibly. Looking at this fight, it seems pretty even in terms of kills to death for both players, like, basically, well, for both teams, basically equal numbers of paladins being traded there for Finland and China, whilst both Plumedarham is mostly untouched. But the thing that it did do was it just allowed Finland to bring Trebs forward. This castle has gone, and Finland also able to get at least one trebuchet firing at this other forward castle of Yo, who is down to two castles now, whereas Pike is on five. So the production is going to be so much better for him. And the other thing is that Pike, as the Mayans sustained production out of that five castles with 115 villages and 20 fishing ships, whereas Yo just 70 villages. So, you know, if Pike so chooses, he could easily go into other stuff like siege rams and stuff like that, whereas Yo, kind of lacking the economy to maintain an army of a lot of plumed archers and then adding in siege ram, researching and adding in siege ram and stuff like that. Finland looked to be in a much better position to here to me. And for China, it's basically going to be a case of, is their Mongol player able to make progress through the game faster than Zuppi and come to their aid? But the first one to click up out of Zuppi and Lix is actually going to be Zuppi, which, given that I've just pinned China's hopes on Lix getting into the game, if Zuppi beats him to that, they're going to be in an absolute world of trouble. Just going to have a quick resources check between the two players. Like, Lix is going to click any moment, but doesn't have a terribly big economy and 67 villages and no fishing ships. That's not enough to go Imperial Age Mongols army composition. No way he's going to be able to do Elite Mangudine Siege and stuff for a long time to come. Whereas Zuppi, lacking the resources, but at least he's up. And he does have basically the same villages as Lix, but importantly, as I keep emphasising, but I can't emphasise the importance of it enough, he's still taking advantage of all the fish, which means that given that he's got such a great food economy on the water, he can concentrate with mostly wood and gold on the land. And China, although they don't know that Zuppi is going to hit the Imperial Age, like, Pike and Max together have done a good enough job here. China just banked on Yo's Imperial Age push whilst receiving Sling being enough, but to me it seemed pretty weak. Like, the upgrades came late, the numbers came late, and the fact that Finland played for the water really helped, because when Finland were fish booming with their pocket, well, pockets is a bit of a kind of an interesting term on this map, because it's almost like, if you're thinking about the water, it's almost two pockets on one flank, because you can only go around the water on the right hand side. But anyway, with Finland, the fact that they had two players fish booming with safe fish, whereas China didn't, it meant that Finland's players advanced through the game so much faster than they would do if this was, for example, Arabia, and they caught up to the Slung player a lot more quickly than they otherwise would. And that meant that Yo didn't have very long to push into Zuppi's base, and just a few layers of stone walls bought Pike in particular the time that he needed to catch up to where Yo was and ultimately get very far ahead of him, because he had such a bigger economy to quickly beat Yo in terms of production. And Yo's push having been the thing that China laid all the emphasis on, and then being pushed back, was basically the game. And again, just to emphasise the importance of the water, we just saw Max being a step ahead of Love Cheng Yinghua for basically the entire game, just because of that fish boom. And importantly, well, not necessarily importantly, but just interestingly, Finland, given that they had the water control, also just moving to the edges of the map, starting to get a little bit of economy with all these extra resources as well. Didn't decide the game in any way, but could have done if the game had lasted another 20 minutes, 30 minutes. These would have been picked civs. They were basically tournament settings. This isn't a tournament in itself, but they played it very seriously and for prize money and with set maps like a tournament. So 2-0 Finland. Very, very strong performances thus far. And I think that in that game in particular, their overall strategy was just much, much better. So once again, I'm just going to have a couple of minutes of music and then I'll do game 3. See you in a moment.